Hey, what's up everyone, welcome to Profit Data. Today exactly I'm going to talk about sub process. Okay, so this, why this sub process? Because you can use this sub process to run n number of files. Okay, so here you know, sub process is like it will, like, you know, pop up executable files. You can with the help of sub process you can run your Python files. You can list those Python files in this program. Okay, and you can just say call the sub process, and if you just you can run your model, okay, whichever you want. Okay, say suppose if you want to you know, store your data in a Kite ticker. Okay, so what you can do is, like, you can store it, you know, you can run an executable file, and if you want to automate your trades with the help of you know, this sub process, you just have to run. Say suppose if you are running some strategies and you are particularly following some you know, stocks which has to be run on the indicator and has to follow that steps. So all you have to do is, like, you can follow these steps, and from outside you can what you can do is, like, you just have to list out those name of the file, and then exactly can run. Okay, so all you have to call is, like, you have to say about from sub process. Okay, so you know, whenever you're choosing this one, you know, you should be on that folder. Okay, so suppose I'm running my this super 10 strategy, exactly this sub process which I'm running here. So exactly what happens here, I am this main file super 10 you know, indicator I want to run. Okay, and I want to follow my stocks crude oil, and I want to place the order. So I have to run this one, and at the same time what happens, I have to run my Kite ticker data to save those datas, and exactly you know, fetch those datas and able to perform operations. Okay, so what happens, I just have to set the folder. So call in a folder will be different, and calling the main file from here exactly will be different. So exactly I'm in that folder, and then calling from another folder, and this. So exactly how you can list those things to call, you know, it's a very much simple process, and all you have to do is, like, import sub process. You know, if you want to install sub process, all you have to do is pip install sub process. That's it. It is simple. It will get installed for you. Okay, and documentation is there which you can follow. It is easy. So that's it, done. And the next, you definitely need a time, because if your coding is efficient and good, you definitely no need to clash each and everything. So you can give some time. So if it is, like, no, it should not get any error. If it is getting error, particularly executable files won't stay. So all you have to do, time, and with the help of this one you can avoid the clash. Next, what happens, all you have to say is p open, and just say Python, it is Python file, and just name the you know, Kite, whichever folder is there, and after folder the name of the file. That's it. If it is in folder, if it's in state, how you can do, I just show you, and just give some time over there. So this is demo purposes. I am already running a file. Okay, and you know that in the previous video I have been explained about this task scheduler. Okay, so here also you can run this file. You just name it, and if you run this file, what happens, that from this it will be taken care of. So, like, you know, sub process modules, you know, sub process modules can be maintained from here, and it maintains efficiently. What you can do is, like, say suppose you are running some strategies for some stocks, and it definitely need to be follow price by price. Okay, as I did in Renko chart, so it has need to be a proper follow. So this is definitely will help you in this one. This is you know, very good stuff to run files and maintain multiple strategies, and to run this one. So if you want to automate, you will definitely know, you don't want to run each and everything, just getting into folder and want to run. Particularly what you can do is, like, just call from a sub process. What if it will pop up executable files and run for you. So it is, like, you know, efficient. It is one of the best. Okay, and you can, like, you know, you can use your own how you exactly want to call. You can call one more you know, file and say this is listed, and run in executable file. Run in executable file means this just a executable file will pop up, and it will be taken care of each and everything. And if you want to cancel, it will be just this one. But what I prefer is, like, if you are following a stocks, it will be like several other scheduler. Okay, and the next I need to run my main file of Super10, which is this. So I can do this. So this is just demo purposes. I am already running in the background executable file. So I just want to show you how you can do. Okay, so you can try. So as you see, these two things has been pop up. First is like for running this one, as you can see the data which I already filled it out, so it's filling over there, and you know, it's getting so this which you can do, my data has already been filled, so all you have to do is like minimize, and if you want to get cancelled, just simple cancel them. And suppose if it is listed, I mean, if you want to call from sub process to main, you can create a main and call all the sub process at a time. So this will definitely gonna help you. Okay, and yes, the point is whenever you are storing in a folder, you just check those things, because what happens if you are you know, out from that folder, it starts saving this. So you can call it from here also, it is a good, you just no need folder and just save that you know, SQL or CSV, it is good. So one and the same, you can try for yourself how you want to go and can use these things. Okay guys, I'll wind it up here. Thanks for watching. If you want to support the Profit Data, the link will be on your left side to the upper part. And thanks for watching. Please do like, share and subscribe. If you have any doubt regarding this video, you can comment below, or if you have any other queries or requirements, it's below in the description. You can follow that link and can WhatsApp number is available if you want to just message me, or you know, contact me, you can contact me via WhatsApp. Thank you.